A blessed evening to everyone, and welcome to our prayerful midweek refill. This evening, our reflection will be led by Sister Andrea Bell.
Fill my cup, Lord, I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul.
Let us pray. O God of peace, who taught us that in return and in rest we shall be saved, in quietness and confidence shall be our strength, by the might of your Spirit lift us, we pray, to your presence, where we may be still and know that you are God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. At this time, we will have our evening Bible reading.
A reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 4, reading from verse 2 to 6. In that day the branch of the Lord shall be beautiful and glorious, and the fruit of the land shall be the pride and honor of the survivors of Israel. And he who is left in Zion and remains in Jerusalem will be called holy. Everyone who has been recorded for life in Jerusalem. When the Lord shall have washed away the filth of the daughters of Zion and cleansed the bloodstains of Jerusalem from its midst by a spirit of judgment and by a spirit of burning. Then the Lord will create over the whole site of Mount Zion and over her assemblies a cloud by day and smoke and the shining of a flaming fire by night. For over all the glory there will be a canopy. There will be a booth for shade by day from the heat and for a refuge and a shelter from the storm and rain. The word of the Lord. This evening's refill is about hope. Hope is defined as a feeling of expectation and desire for a certain thing to happen. Born in Jerusalem, Isaiah was called to be a prophet in the year of King Uzziah's death. Isaiah saw a vision and prophesied the coming of the Messiah, Jesus Christ. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 1. We see in Isaiah chapter 3 where the Lord brings judgment on Judah and Jerusalem for their disobedience in turning from God and following other gods. He will remove whatever it is in our way that keeps his people from him, but only in order that we might enjoy his glory. Because of this, we as people of God can and should have hope in God's perfect purpose for our lives. Some of us are losing that hope, and it is natural to become despondent in these circumstances under COVID-19. Many of us are starting to lose hope in the temporary, that the government will not lift the curfews, losing hope that our finances will take a dive and leave us in a dire situation. Losing hope that our health conditions are deteriorating and is causing us further hardship. Losing hope that our children are not motivated and interested in school and schoolwork. And losing hope that we will not soon be able to worship under the roof of St. George's. But we as Christians are called not to rely on the temporary, but on God. Our hope is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And while it is hard to see any light in this tunnel called COVID-19, we must continue to cling to the one true thing, that is Jesus Christ. For his dying he has cleansed us, and his rising restored us, giving us the Holy Spirit until he comes again. The prophet Isaiah described a future that only the Messiah could achieve. Isaiah, on seeing the holiness of God, cried out, "Woe is me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then the seraphim flew to me, having in his hand a burning coal that he had taken with thongs from the altar. And he touched my mouth and said, "Behold, this has touched your lips. Your guilt is taken away and your sin is forgiven." Isaiah chapter 6, verse 6 to 7. The branch also represents the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world, Jesus the Messiah. Isaiah refers back to the day of the Exodus and Israel's wandering in the wilderness when they were being guided by the pillar of fire and cloud. Exodus chapter 13, verse 21. And the Lord went before them by day in a pillar of cloud to lead them along the way, and by night in a pillar of fire to give them light, that they might travel by day and by night. God takes care of his chosen people. Even when we cannot see him, God is our protection from the heat and rain. He will chastise us for our continuous disobedience and lack of trust in him by following after other gods, but he still offers us hope. My message is, in spite of our situation, let us continue to trust God, even though we are unable to see his whole plan for our lives. During our wandering and waiting to get back to our lives before COVID-19, we must never lose hope, but continue to rely on him for guidance, his wisdom, his protection. And all these things can be found in his true words, the Holy Bible, in which we have our promised hope. Jesus was manifested in the flesh, vindicated by the Spirit, seen by the angels, proclaimed among the nations, believed on in the world, taken up in glory. Yes, Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us focus on this hope and not be distracted by our circumstances. Let us pray. Be thou our vision, O Lord of our hearts. Be thou our wisdom and our true word. Lord, help us to hear you saying, "I am your hope," over all the other voices. We turn to you with both hands stretched out and grabbing onto you. Fill us with hope, and give us a tangible reminder today that hope is an unbreakable spiritual lifeline. May the God of hope fill us with all the joy and peace as we trust you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
As we come out of this time of quiet reflection and meditation, I invite us to pray using the words which our Savior taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Grant to your servants, O God, to be set on fire with your love, to be strengthened by your power, to be illuminated by your Spirit, to be filled with your grace, and to move on with your help through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do have a restful night.